Turndown for Wall just made a video about how Kola is back in the community and he is winning CEO 2024 and all the stuff that led up to it. And hey, time to add another victory in the books because Kola just won the Luminosity Invitational number 2 with honestly an insane amount of wins. I don't even think I remember them all, and I was following the tournament very closely, so we're going to be watching two of the sets of the tournament. We're going to be watching his winner semi set versus Oshimo, because that's a run back from the GIM Invitational forever ago, and then grand final set 2 versus Spargo. Like, just as a quick recap, Kola came in the 15th seed of 16 players. The only player he was seeded above was Zapkos. He was the last seed of the second seeded pool, which was Sonics, and his run included victories over Shiny Mark, Light, losing to Sonics, and then in bracket, he beat Leo, Oshimo, Shutone, and Spargo. That's crazy. Kola is back, one of the most amazing players to watch, super fun, so let's get into the matches. So game one, we have Ryu versus Roy. I actually don't know how this matchup is. I do know that Kola does have experience in this matchup, as there are multiple Shoto players in his region. I don't know if Jazo ever goes Ryu versus him, or if he opts to only go Ken, but also there's Vendetta as well. Vendetta, these probably top two strongest Ryu in the US, him and Aiken are the main two that I think of. Nice F-tilt by Oshimo, though. Oshimo's been on a tear. Again, I had a video about him winning a major recently. If you want to check it out, it'll be in the card up above in the corner. So, you know, Oshimo has had some crazy wins recently, including beating Akola literally last weekend, I'm pretty sure, is when he won his major. So he was on quite a run himself. I think he beat Tweak to get here, the first time he's ever done that, and that matchup seems so bad. So, you know, Oshimo can do anything, and I'm pretty sure Oshimo won their only other bout. I don't know if they've played more times than the Invitational, but that's just the one I remember, because Oshimo had like a crazy insane combo with that tournament. Actually, did Oshimo win that? Oh no, Kola won that. I'm sorry. I thought that the Invitational, that, I mean, maybe he just made a comeback after that crazy combo, so that's my bad. So that is going to be, I believe he won 3-2 in that first set as well. So, you know, this is going to, wait, where did his first stock go? Oh, right, the back of the down air, I remember. But yeah, Oshimo, insane. This matchup seems like pretty even because both players kind of get to bully each other. The fact that Roy has up B can kind of get out of some of the down tilt pressure, but of course if Ryu shields at any point during that, it can be really hard. Nice side B to get that first kill, but down, he's at super death percent versus Ryu. Okay, gets that nair, but no follow-up, and Oshimo dashes back in with the down tilt Tatsu. No Shoryu's, just because he's getting the tipper spacing of those down tilts. He's not, like, really inside the body of his hitbox, so that is why he's not going for those Shoryu's. Nice nair. Ooh, good string. The edge guards of this matchup can be pretty ruthless as far as I'm aware, but the reversal there with the up air up he was honestly insane. Focus could have let it rip because it definitely would have punished the spot dodge that Kola went for, but not gonna matter. There's down smash Hadouken. We had the ledge trapping. Ryu's edge trapping is pretty oppressive, and Oshimo's itself is definitely the best of all the Ryu's. So down a stock, what can Kola do in this? Because hey, this is a video about Kola. Why am I talking about Oshimo so much? He gets the nair, no tech chase there. Nice back air on the whiffed jab, just making it really, really difficult to know where he wants to be. So Kola's really unable to get these big hits, except for that side B yet again, and that is going to be once more even stocks. Oh, didn't get the fast fall on that nair, so wasn't able to get multiple nairs, only able to get grab, which is not going to be as good of a confirm. Focus is out because of that frame one. Definitely needs to be that nair or up B in order to get around that focus in advantage. Okay, tries to get the jab for the jab Shoryu because it also sucks you in. So 50% lead for Oshimo, but is that enough? I don't know. Nice back air tracking the movement. Didn't go for a deeper edge guard because it was quite an awkward position, but the up B out of shield on that Roy jab. It is pretty unsafe, especially in the corner when there's not going to be that pushback. Game one, Oshimo. Kola gonna run it back to PS2. I feel like the stage wasn't really influential in the matchup. I feel like maybe the only thing is it is wide, so Oshimo was able to run away just a little bit more, but I don't know what Oshimo banned, so I can't be like, oh, he should go to Smash World, he should go to blah blah blah, because like maybe he wasn't able to. Nice cancel on that, making the up air ambiguous whether he wants to special cancel or not, which is going to make it just essentially safe, because if you have to worry about a move they're randomly gonna throw out after their move comes out, then you're gonna hold shield, which is gonna make it safe. Fair out of shield, not going to hit. Cola definitely with a much closer game this time. No early forward tilt into spike there, but unable to get these tech chases. And Oshimo didn't get the jump forward from that downer, so no stock, but another back air. He's the back air bandit, man. Rolling out of that down tilt, very smart by Cola, trying to get these side Bs to just beat out any type of option, but not going to be a full combo. Just fell out of it, and then the down tilt into Tatsu is going to come out for Oshimo, and now we have a scramble. The ledge pressure for Cola, nice reaction, dash grab back. Tries to get the neutral B, didn't hit the 2-frame though. Okay, that's a punish. Oh, misses the tech chase just by timing. He was right on the option, and the back air came out for Ryu first. It's faster than Roy's, so that is going to be a stock lead for Oshimo. Again, not as big of a lead as last game, so Cola definitely only needs like one big hit in order to bring it back. But what is the kind of lead that Oshimo's going to get? Nice back throw. Kind of interesting he went for back throw, not like a down throw. Potential tech chase, the heavy jab. 64% already on Cola. What happened? I feel like it was even just a second ago, and now it's at 83%, and Cola can't seem to get this kill. Forward air. Side B not going to connect properly, and even if it did, it wouldn't have been the sweet spot, so it was not going to be the kill. And Oshimo is just impossible to get any big hits on, and that's going to be the one up tilt into the dash upper shoryu. It's honestly crazy that this connects. I feel like this is so far. Like, the up air itself, I feel like, is absolutely so, like, look at that. But the up air, I guess, drags down, right, to make the multi-hit work, and so canceling into that shoryu in the middle of the move is going to connect properly. Down smash not going to work, and suddenly it's a 3-stock to 1-stock lead. That's worse than last game, but that side B makes it only a normal 1-stock lead. Oh god, JB3. Oh, that tech chase was gross. It was a red fireball. It was a parry. No, sorry, I thought it was a parry into down smash, red fireball, down smash, Hadouken, not true combo, but catches the dash in, and then the F tilt into down air. Really, really good stuff by Oshimo. JB3. I didn't see this set except for literally the very end, so I have no idea how Cola brings this back, because that was a JB3, runs it back to PS2. I wonder what adjustments he has to make, right? Because that was kind of, like, I mean, he needs to get the early kills, right? He needs to hit those Jairs, he needs to hit some edge guards, because that's, like, a big thing about Ryu, and also, I guess he needs to hit these tech chases, so maybe just making those couple of adjustments is going to be what wins Cola the game. Yeah, tries to get the jab at the ledge there, but not gonna hit its mark. Flistool's out of the situation. Side B gets Oshimo off and gets him off stage yet again. There's jab back air. I think if Oshimo DI'd down in a way, he wouldn't have been able to actually get that kill just based on the percent, but I could be wrong about that. But now Cola for the first time with the lead. Full hop rising fair, going to be so good to call out jumps. Then you get literally 57% when there was also armor in that. Tries to counter the uppie, but I think you have to be off stage for that to really work. And suddenly the momentum for Cola. He's literally just hitting his tech chases, and he got an early kill instead of Oshimo living into like 170. So there's jab jab shoryu though. That is going to be the stock for Oshimo. But right now we still have a quite large lead for Cola. Gets that jab. See, that's the DI I was talking about. You definitely have to preemptively DI a lot against Roy, but then when they start mixing up F tilts and then you're DIing down and away, you're just going to explode off stage. So now full stock lead for Cola. Down throw jab, nair, it would have also beat the focus. Nice air dodge there, I like that. Didn't want to give Oshimo a potential parry, so he just air dodges to get out of the way. Uppy not going to hit its mark, but down smash red fireball will be the punish into dash attack on the landing. Honestly, crazy. Oshimo did not hesitate, but he waited a little bit to make sure that he wasn't going to. The first hit of up air didn't connect there, so the shoryu did not work. Okay, no tech chase, but has Oshimo in the corner, uses that dash back side B. Again, it's really, really good to use dash back side Bs, like if you have a special like that, to immediately stop your momentum, because you don't have to go through your entire dash back animation to still get a hit, which is like really, it's why it works so often, because you're not expecting that timing to be able to come out. Neutral get ups there, the cardinal sin of versus Roy. Roy had a crazy tournament here as well, just obviously Cola, but then Spargo getting a win, another win on Sonics with the Roy in losers, that Trump back air, mwah, so clean, so fast. Cola with the 2-stock that game, made the necessary adjustments, again, just kind of hit a little bit harder and got some early kills, that was literally all you need, so that the Ryu's not living to 150, 160, getting max utilization of that rage, and now we have a game 4. Oh no, Oshimo goes FD. Okay, yeah, I do like this for Oshimo. I feel like it is very good for specifically Ryu. Like not necessarily Ken, but Ryu specifically is very good on the stage, because the fireballs just become really annoying to deal with, because you can't just like land on platform and wait. You have to like time your jumps and stuff like that. It becomes a little bit more Street Fighter like. And Ryu likes those simplified game states a lot. There's the Nair, gets the tech chase. Ow, that's a kill. He got nared at 72. He got heavy up tilt, or whatever move that is, heavy jab, at 80, and he died. He hella died, too. It wasn't even close. Okay, there's the nair fair. What can Cola do? Is he going to get the downer two frame? No, he's not. He jumped a little too early, showed his hand, and the double jump wasn't able to get there soon enough. So Oshimo suddenly racking on this percent. Cola has to do an amazing comeback here. Obviously, he does because we're talking about the video, and I said that he already beat him. So, yeah, not going to get the tech chase, or sorry, the ledge trap immediately. No jab back here, double focus. No downer on the two frame either. Saibi not going to be the sweet spot, so not going to be the kill either. Yeah, and Oshimo gets another down tilt, strong down tilt, red fireball. And that is going to be more damage. There's a jab back here. Caught Oshimo, trying to hold forward. There's the bad DI. And that's going to be even stocks, but still hefty lead for Oshimo. I like that empty jump, but it's not going to matter. Nair, jab, jab, sure. He didn't actually get the kill. I'm kind of surprised. I like that he goes for those jab ledge traps. I think that's very interesting because the jab brings you in. Yeah, short hop nair not going to work for Oshimo. That double down tilt will. Tried to go for the tech chase because I don't think he expected Cola to DI in a way that he could get the Tatsu kill, or maybe just wouldn't have killed there. No, okay, never mind. Gets the ledge trap still, but not going to be kepting at the ledge technically, but ooh, tries to go for the Jeff smash, but not going to hit. 73%, that's going to be a back air. Is that going to kill? Oh my god, Roy with rage is crazy. 73 on Ryu? On Ryu? He's heavy. And that's going to be the stock, so Cola has the lead all of a sudden, just able to put your opponents in the corner. I'm so blessed that I play a character with quick attack, so I don't have to worry about ledge trapping very often. So thanks, Pikachu, I appreciate it. Okay, there's down tilt into Tatsu. No strong down tilt, just to make sure that there's no DI to potentially get out of that combo. Down throw nair, gonna get, Ryu out of the focus. That's going to be a punish on that getup attack. No double jump, no down air. Again, the ledge trapping this game has been really, really intense for Cola. So, like, Oshimo's been unable to do anything because of these jabs, down tilts. He's just guessing right a lot. And if he's not, he's just reacting very, very well with those, like, rolls. Again, dash back, side B yet again, 96 to 26. Great lead for Cola. But Oshimo back in neutral. What is he able to do? There's a weak fair. That's going to be a good combo. Ow, so that did, like, 50. Jesus, off of a weak fair? Insane pressure right there. That should be a punish. No true punish, but then knowing that Oshimo is going to shield because of the potential of a punish, that he gets the grab, very, very smart. Misses the RAR, and that's a lot of focuses to try to get out of these bad positions. There's going to be a grab in the corner. Once again, this ledge trap has been oppressive for Cola. Gets the nair, no follow-up confirmed. Didn't expect it to hit. It was also the very, very late hit of nair. Oh, misses. Oh, God, the focus moves to the wrong side. That was set for Oshimo if he just turned it around. He didn't, though, so Cola has another chance to win this game again. He is winning by percent, but that absolutely should have been game. Strong down tilt. Up smash, not gonna be the kill. Honestly, I really like that decision because it's like dash cancelable, but then no F tilt there. Double rolls, everyone's panicking. This is slopping. The nair goes through the other side. Cola pops off. That makes sense. That was a really, really tense, kind of scary, weird, awful game ender. And so Cola goes up that game to bring it to 2-2. Game 5 coming up. Oshimo goes back to FD, which again, I don't dislike. I mean, he did get ledge trapped, so maybe platforms would help him be able to like ledge jump air dodge and trying to get in a bad position that way, or get out of the bad position, sorry, because, oh, the jab F smash, that's gonna be the stock. That percent just literally went through the focus, or was it a dash cancel? It's hard to tell. I don't think he was able to dash cancel yet, but he did focus, but there is a damage threshold that you can beat if you are hitting focus really, really early, and it just goes through it entirely, and Roy's F smash is absolutely gonna beat that. It is so strong. So now we have Cola with an entire stock lead, basically, on FD. Oshimo's counterpick, bringing it back from game 5 because he was already down 2-0, double up air, back air. Cola's playing nice. That down air did hit, and then it sent into the stage, so Oshimo needed to tech that, but why would you know you have to tech that? So Cola now with a 2-stock lead, double nair, triple nair, actually. I thought he was going to go for double fair there. Weak up air. This is just looking so dominant for Cola. It's so hard to bring this back. When Cola has this momentum, he's like the best player in the world. I mean, as kind of shown by how many players he beat and the fact that he won this event. When you have momentum, it's just, you're just really good. You're just so good. No edgeguard there because of that focus, but either way, the ledge trap now resumes. Okay, gets for the fair. Oshimo does get back on stage. Ugh, dude, that offstage side B. Oh, and then the flare blade offstage. They cut it a little early, but that flare blade is going to be so nice. That was the only potential way for Oshimo to recover, or he could have done I guess like a lower jump shoryu, but this also probably would have hit that. The flare blade does get the kill. That solidifies the reverse 3-0. The three victories for Cola in that reverse 3-0 were a JV3, a scramble last hit, clencher, and then a three stock. So very, very good play by him right now. Let's hop over to grand finals. Cola did beat Shutone in winner's finals with a combination of Roy versus Aegis and Cloud versus Olimar, and then he had to fight Spargo, reset the bracket versus him. Spargo started the event in losers and had a crazy losers run of, let me see if I remember who it was. So Spargo's losers run started with Sonics with the Roy, and then he beat Meister, and then he beat Light, and then he beat Ashimo, and then he beat Zomba, and then he beat Shutone, and then he beat Cola in set one. So this is the eighth set in losers for Spargo. Down throw jab to start it off. I do like the small battlefield pick for both of them. Obviously, the slightly smaller stage is going to benefit Roy because he's a little slower, so you are going to have that close quarter combat, a little bit better. But of course, the platform's obviously amazing for Aegis. Down air, he's just calling out Spargo's options. I mean, we literally just saw Cola have really, really strong ledge trapping against Ashimo. So is that going to be the theme of this set? I don't know. I didn't watch it. I looked at my phone and I saw that Cola won, but I don't know how or like. I don't even know the set count. I do know that the set one was 3-1 in Spargo's favor just in this matchup, right? Spargo's Aegis, one of the best in the world. I don't know if I give him best Aegis in the world just because he doesn't really play it super often. Normally would give that title to Shutone, who mostly mains that character and then sometimes plays Olimar. Nice combo by... Spargo to just get that little bit more damage with the raw air-to-air there with the double jump back here. So good. Like, Aegis is oftentimes going to be on the ground or fall hopping, because I do think that Roy wins the short hop aerial game with Nair and forward air compared to Aegis's. Like, if she does a rising aerial, then you get punished, whereas Roy does it, it's a little bit safer unless you, like, foresight one of the hits or something. So it's going to be a little bit scarier for Aegis to just be short hopping around. So the full hop is going to come out, which means that you are able to read that with that double jump back air for Cola. Also, it was off of a platform, which makes it even better. Big lead starting up for Cola here, 62%, and Spargo unable to get this kill. 112, no ledge trap there, just doesn't hit the ledge jump, which is super hard to do. Spargo also does really like ledge jump. Is it going to be the ledge trap? No, doesn't get the jab punish. So that's a forward throw, and is this going to be the ledge trap for him? Yeah, dude, he flashes his shield there. It's really interesting. I don't know if he's flashing his shield to like just try to like hit a get up attack, but it seems like he's reacting to some type of like movement, right? Because he flashes his shield once Spargo starts moving, right? Because this is like, let's try to do the frames, right? So like, I think the get up probably starts like about there, somewhere around here. So like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and then 13 he hits his shield. So it seems like he's reacting to this, trying to flash his shield for a getup attack, and then knows that it is timed for a wonderful dash back into back throw to continue the ledge trap. That could have actually been a better position for Cola. I forget how safe that back air is, actually. Let me double check. So back air is -9. That's what I thought. I thought it was -9, and then uppy, I believe, is frame 8 for Roy. Oh no, it's frame 9. So yeah, it is a perfect punish every single time, which means you can always get a big punish on the up B. Tries to get the side B there, but speaking of up B punishes, that up B is going to go absolutely crazy. So 101%. So Spargo obviously a death percent, and he literally immediately gets a kill. This reminds me of how he won CEO 2024 just on the raw like fast fall air dodge read against Riddles. So Cola, again, when he has momentum, he's just like, he's gonna be on, and it's gonna be fantastic. Again, it's crazy to me that he was the 15th seed of this tournament. Obviously, no shade to Cola, there was just a bunch of amazing players. Like, I feel like at worst maybe Mars is under him, but Mars just got 9th at Supernova, so like, you know, what are you gonna do? Oh, that could have been a punish by Cola. He was a little slow, actually. So missing out on some damage, but still has a solid lead. Jab into side B, nice, gets Spargo off stage. Ooh, hits the downer 2-frame into forward smash. For some reason, I feel like I've never seen that, but it makes sense given how downer works. That's honestly crazy that it hit. It felt like the downer was so far. Oh, I guess the hand was inside the stage, yeah. So 2-framing is such a weird mechanic sometimes, where just like, oh, their hand is like through the stage for some reason, so therefore it hits really far. Downer, F smash. Downer is just such a good 2-frame, and I don't think Spargo had a jump, so that is going to be a mandatory air dodge frame to even pretend to make it back, and that is going to be an easy jump off stage. I do like the fact, it's very cool that like Marth, Lucina, Roy, Krom, their back air turns them around, so they are able to just jump off and do back air to turn around. They don't have to do some type of raw or anything like that. Not like it really matters, you can still just do that anyway. anyway. But that's going to be game one for Cola. And again, this down air is just so crazy here, because in this position, right, it's either going to spike if it gets the sweet spot and get a kill, or it's going to combo into things like back air, up air, or that percent forward smash. So that's honestly insane. 69%. Nice. That's why it worked. And that is going to be game one for Cola. Well, let's see where Spargo's going to counterpick. Okay, PS2 makes sense. I feel like it helps the faster character. Bigger stage is better for faster characters typically, or the characters that want to camp. And Aegis is a campy character because she's so fast. Gets a good combo. Oh, actually misses the uppie. Great DI by Cola. And then he mashes out immediately. Maybe could have got a bigger punish on the floor, but also that has such little lag. That should be a downer. No, Spargo misses it. Jab on the two frame. Downer doesn't get the sweet spot. So both players potentially having stocks there. Not going to be it. And that's not going to be a sweet spot for Cola, but still Spargo getting some good damage here. Oh, nice back air. Nice down tilt, dude. I really feel like what makes Spargo and Shutone's Aegis just so scary is the fact that their Pyras are terrifying. Okay, tries to get a hard read in. Does Cola. It would have been the stock, so I don't blame him. You know, just trying to make sure, like, even if you're wrong there, it's like, hey, ow, that was so much damage. Even if you're wrong in this position, right, you're kind of just like, hey, you shouldn't be going for rolls in. And so now Cola, after that, can kind of do some really solid, just like tech chases with tech in place and tech away. But here, Spargo with the great roll in. That's got so much damage, dude. That was like 35 for a comp for a character that's not really supposed to combo you. No double jump online. Didn't get anything. The down tilt up air, not going to kill that time. But will the next up air? Dude, this juggle is crazy. It's so, oh, that down air would have been so nice by Spargo as well. Yeah, you can also up B the Nairs. Oh, up smash not gonna work, so the forward smash really lucky for Cola. There is no scoop hitbox on the backside of Mithra's up smash, just the front side, so really, really fortuitous turn of events there. Directional air dodge, but Spargo's still able to cover it, and that's gonna be an up B. This should be the stock, just the rinse repeat. Nope, tries to go for something different. The up B comes out, but the foresight on the hit, one of Nair, that is gonna be the stock. Down tilt combo, misses the back air, tried to optimize the damage just a little bit, but sometimes it's better to not hit the optimal damage just by hitting slightly more damage with the simpler combo. Let's see if Spargo learns or like lives to regret that forward smash. Not gonna get the kill. Oh my god, I really thought it was gonna kill. High side B, great stuff by Spargo, recognizing that Cola jumped out just a little early to get this edge guard. Like, this is kind of the counterplay to edge guarding, right? It's like you notice when people are jumping out at you, and you notice like, oh, the position's not super perfect. Like, how is Cola gonna hit that? He would have to hard commit with jump forward fair, which loses to literally every other option. So great early side B, but then Cola still brings this back again, literally missing that up B, missed out on percent, and then put him in a bad situation that he really never got out of. But Spargo still good damage here, has Spargo at 86, 93%. The disadvantage, I mean, this is why Aegis is a good character, right? It's just like she can just do this over and over. Down tilt down smash gonna be the kill. Yes, it will. Jesus, that is Mithra, baby. And that's why Cosmo says, I don't even need to go Pyra, I can just kill you with Mithra. Cola counterpicks back to small battlefield again. The stage worked out for him. The slightly less big stage again is going to be good for the character that wants to do the rush down, the one that is not going to be as good at camping. Spargo doesn't miss the combo there, so a solid 41%. That's the combo he was trying to get basically on the platform. Misses the chroma dust though. No, oh, I thought he didn't have a double jump. I was gonna say, geez, this advantage state for Spargo, he's literally hitting Cola and just not letting him land. Like, he got hit like twice this entire stock. Like, when did he get in disadvantage? So we hit Cola at 56 with a forward tilt, and it killed. Essentially, this was all because of that. The forward smash two frame, it's crazy that moved two frames. And then the rinse repeat of the drop off reverse chroma dusts into, yeah, that's just so strong. Aegis is a good character, y'all. Roy might be better, but Aegis is a very good character. Oh, tried to get some type of air dodge read with the downer, but not going to hit its mark. Double dash there. Call it Mario Kart the way he double dash in against your shield. Okay, really solid damage for Spargo, just extending this lead, and again, not letting Cola land. This advantage has been really oppressive. I do want to see Cola hit these Nairs a little bit more. Maybe that's an adaptation he makes later in the set, because again, every single time Aegis does a Nair on your shield, sorry, Mithra specifically does a Nair on your shield, it is punishable because it is minus 10, and you can up B it every time. If it's in front of you, you can grab it or up smash it potentially. I don't actually know the frame data of Roy's up smash, so I'm not going to speak on that. Yeah, frame 12, so you can't do that, so you know, I'm glad I didn't speak on it. I'm glad I just shut up. And if you want me to just shut up, leave me down a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe, turn on notifications, and ring the bell. I would appreciate it for more content from the Luminosity Invitational. Side B getting Spargo through the center. It's been so, like, that's like the best way to use Side B by far for Aegis, just getting off of the ledge. It's really, really hard to deal with, especially like jump back Side B, and then Shuton does it a lot. He does like jump back Side B, and then it's there. He air dodges back to ledge, and then he gets up because now you're basically gone. So high percent right now for Cola, so Spargo is able to clean out the stock pretty soon. Gets the down smash, but it wasn't the sweet spot. But now we have the Chroma Dust Rust. Rinse and repeat is what I meant to say. Goes for a forward air there. I thought it was going to be a down air, but yeah, there's the Chroma Dust. No double jump. You are dead there. So full stock lead for Spargo. Seemed like he's going to go up 2-1 in this set. So what can he do to either bring it back this game? That was 41%, 47%. This advantage is crazy for Spargo. This is just what you do when you're Aegis. When Aegis jumps high, maybe that's the time to directional air dodge. But I don't know if you end up getting away from the pressure. Oh, forward smash at the ledge. Almost a comeback again, high Side B. No, the swaps are going to be so good. I feel like that was really, really smart, in my opinion, for Cola to go for that back air, but Spargo just wanted center stage more than anything. There's the down air back air. That's what I was talking about, kind of with the two frame thing, where you can get just like down air back air, which is honestly insane. Spargo with a big lead. He basically just needs one solid hit to get this kill. Ooh, tries to go for footstool down out of shield, but does a full hop footstool instead of a short hop footstool. Welcome to the peculiarities of footstool, everybody. And that is going to be not the kill, so Cola still has a chance to bring this back again. Very explosive. And of course, the fact that Aegis is edge guardable means that you can possibly bring it back at all times versus this character. But the ledge trap, down tilt, up air, that's still connected? That's crazy. I 100% thought that wasn't going to connect. Like, this combo felt fake here. How did that even work? Crazy. I guess he does the down tilt for the ledge jump, and then he jabs the neutral get up. So really good, just solid option coverage. Insane that that worked. Cole is a little surprised as well. So 2-1 for Spargo. Cole is going to run it back to small battlefield, which again, I agree with. He just needs to not get advantaged for 30 seconds at a time, and he's going to be fine. Like, that was honestly, that game was crazy. Nice parry. He goes for parry drop through upper, but he simply won't upbeat it, which is insane to me. Good damage. Oh, misses the uppie yet again. So Cola getting a bigger punish here. Jab. Ooh, I love the jab down tilt here. So clever just to push, you know, E just a little bit further off stage. Doesn't get the edge guard, but I do like that. I like the reverse as well from Spargo with that neutral B, but the fast fallers will drop out of that combo more often. Gets the tech chase as well. Now Cola's the one keeping Spargo in uncomfortable positions and has a 50% lead. Nairs, that's what I'm talking about with the short hop superiority of Roy. B reverse Side B off of the ledge. He's going to have a double jump, so you are going to have a potential to two frame. No ledge trump either. I don't know if he messed up a ledge hop back air and got ledge jump. I do know that Cola uses tap jump, so maybe just rolled his stick a little too early. He actively jumps with tap jump, which is honestly insane. Like, it's wild. Okay, at up air, really good auto cancel for, ooh, Spargo, but the up tilt, assuming, you know, the way the game works with like the leapfrog over shields, the forward air whiffed, so he up tilts and hits the short hop for Spargo, has the lead, Nair one, not going to be punishable by Pyro. Oh, wow, that parry into down tilt was crazy though. And of course, Pyro's advantage not going to be as threatening or as like option coverage-y as Mithra's, so was able to get down quite quickly. Tries to go for double downer instead of just taking the up smash, but gets it anyway, it doesn't matter. 36% separate these two players, but Cola gets a jab to immediately open up the stock, has to shield the up B, and gets just a run-up grab there. Tried to bait some type of air dodge, but Spargo mashing down with the Nair. He chooses really good times to mash Nair, I feel like. It's been working a lot, but again, that's what I'm talking about. There's the up B. I want to see that adaptation because I think, you know, sometimes you're like, you're just not going to mash this Nair, and then they do it, and you go like, oh, I was surprised. I thought it was going to be like a different timing or like a more, not like more clever, but just like a different option. He actually got that jab back here. Really, really solid stuff. The slight delay after the jump is going to make that work. So now Cola has an entire stock lead this game four. So what can Spargo do? Again, those full hop fairs have been working so well. We saw it versus Oshimo, and again, just getting like fair falling up air is crazy. And again, you're full hopping because again, he has already established the short hop supremacy with his aerial, so he knows that Spargo's gonna full hop, so then he full hops Spargo. Like, Cola's just on, and when he starts reading you, again, reads the full hop in the corner, it's just, it feels unstoppable sometimes when you just, it's just like, oh, he's just right every single time, and then he up, he's out of shield, and I can't get any offense, and he's dashing back, and he's side-being me, and he's up smashing me for air dodging on platform, and this is just this is just dominant right now. This is what Kolda does with momentum. Absolutely insane play right now. And it looks like he's going to bring it to a game five, which, by the way, we already know Spargo or Kolda wins because I'm covering it. So we do know it goes to game five. Great edgeguard right now for Spargo, but misses the final up B jab there on the landing. Aerial swaps into Pyra. Probably going to do something punishable. Yes, but then the up B goes the wrong way, which is why Kolda wasn't doing it. The up tilt, of course, has that blind spot in front of it, which is why a lot of Roy players don't like that move. And again, Spargo doing a full hop footstool instead of a short hop footstool. That would have been stock because that would have been footstool down air, fast fall land on platform, jump double jump up air. But we're bringing it to a game five. And before this, I don't actually remember how often they've played. I do know they played at a Let's Make Moves, I think Miami, maybe last year when Kolda had a good run, but I don't remember their overall set count. So offline before this tournament, they were 1-4 in Spargo's favor. Kolda beating Spargo. I remember that set, yeah, in the top 8 of the Invitational. But Spargo overall winning this pretty consistently. And again, Spargo did win the first set. So this would be the second victory for Kolda against Spargo. Spargo on track to be the number one player in the world right now, even with this performance, right? Winning 2 P tiers as well as 3rd at a different P tier and 2nd place here with a bunch of crazy wins, including wins over the other best players in the world at the moment. So Spargo has an amazing resume right now, but what can Kolda do to take home this victory? Spargo goes to Battlefield to make these juggles a little bit easier for him, because it's so funny, sometimes FD makes juggles easier because it's like, oh well, you don't have platforms to land on, but certain characters like juggling under platforms, so the mashing can't happen. But also, Spargo's been getting a lot off of mashing and disadvantage against Kolda, so this may backfire against him tremendously. Gets the up air uppy there, has the small percent lead, but the downer just YOLO mashing the downer through the platform. Gonna get the 2-frame? No, he won't. Backs up again. He's been getting a lot of dash grabs on these rollbacks. Gets the side B. Honestly, what a crazy tech by Kolda. And then he's trying to dance around Spargo's shield, and it is working. No air dodge, has to go for the up B. Gets the ledge hop aerial. Dude, that dash back was so good. He's been pressuring so often, very close to the ledge. And how did he do that? The timing that he chose to dash back there was crazy, because it's not like he was like, oh, you grabbed the ledge, let me dash back and react. This was literally a, hey, I'm going to land here. He waited like just enough time that he knew, hey, Spargo might see that I'm close here. He's going to ledge hop aerial, dash back. Like that, I can't describe to you how good that was. Oh my god, that was like the most impressive thing he's done so far. Like low-key. Gets a grab there, puts Spargo back in disadvantage, tries to get more up B out of shield again. Everything Aegis does, not everything, but most things Aegis does for both of the characters, assuming there's not a, you know, max spacing, is punishable, right? The frame data isn't safe on shield, it's just so fast. When you're Mithra, it's so fast that it is hard to react to the fact that the move is hitting you. And Pyra, there's a lot of shield pushback, so there's a lot of circumstance where it actually isn't punishable. Gets the double jump, nothing here. Misses the back air there? That was crazy. I can't believe he missed that. That felt like such correct timing. Oh, sorry, the forward air, but he was just slightly off on that, the swap punish. So now Spargo able to forward tilt. That could have been a 3-stock to 1-stock lead for Kolda. Instead, is Spargo going to take the stock? Oh, goes for a YOLO up smash. Doesn't work. Again, Kolda's been jumping, so it makes sense. Neutral got to roll backwards. Spargo is scared. That is 3-stock to 1 for Kolda. This game five. That's what I'm talking about. I feel like the platforms haven't really been helping Spargo. If anything, it's helping Kolda, but also he's just had Spargo at the ledge a ton. Imagine if he gets a 3-stock. Okay, I actually don't know how the game ends. I know, like, I guess the last move he hits with, but I don't know the context in which he hits it. I don't remember how close it was either. So will Spargo make this scary, or is this just going to be a dominant ledge trap, dominant position for Kolda? Because right now it looks super rough for Spargo. He needs to get one of those like long, like 40 second advantage states. Gets up air there, misses the combo. That's not going to be good. No double jump right now. Okay, gets the double jump back, and the Nair landing hitbox doesn't hit. Oh god, so much damage. Actually only 62. It feels like more sometimes when you get hit that many times by Mithra, but not doing a ton of damage other than that up B drop off there into the Nair down. Oh, down air up smash not gonna work, but you know, Spargo working really, really strong right now. 118, that jab not gonna work, but gets the roll in yet again. He already did that once. Air dodging is going to save Kolda, so that is a 67% lead going into final stock. Spargo bringing it back. Of course it's going to last stock. Spargo, it's really hard to just beat Spargo down super hard. Oh god, that up smash was crazy. I forgot what happened. That was crazy. He got 2 up airs before this. Gets the up air, forward air, and then in this context, again, Spargo trying to jump, double jump just around because he can't full hop because he's going to have to land on platform again. These platforms not working out. The up air there, and I guess the only option Spargo had here, low-key, I mean, he could have nared, because I guess up smash isn't fast enough to hit a landing nair, but in this position, you're expecting, like, you need to directional air dodge here, but that weak up air, there's suddenly not a lot of hits on you. You go, oh god, and you panic, and then the up smash on that, the scooping hitbox on both sides, and the immediate pop-off for Cola. I saw that he, like, tears down the set, which I don't want to really get into discourse about that, so we're going to leave it there, but Cola winning Luminosity Invitational number two again. So many wins. Cola is super back. He just won a major, because this was a major, this Invitational, so great stuff to him. And as I've always said, Roy is an amazing character. Cola is one of the scariest players to play when he is on, and he was so on this weekend. Again, only losing to Spargo and Sonix, who most would consider right now two of the top three players in the world. Like, Mia would be the other one, because Mia's won a couple of P tiers. He's not doing as well in North America, so it's hard to tell, right? But Spargo absolutely up there, Sonix absolutely up there, so great stuff by both players. Fantastic. Cola, absolutely insane. I'm going to be going over more runs here. More specifically, I'm going to be going over Leo for sure. And I'll probably go over Spargo's loser's run against a couple of the players he went over. Let me know what other people you want me to go over in the comments down below. I would appreciate it. While you're down there, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you all for watching. As always, social media and partner stuff is down below, and I'll see you all next time. Peace.